Yes, students, today we will do the sample paper, question paper of physics for class 12th 2017-18. That is the latest sample paper. The time allowed is 3 hours and the maximum marks is 70. General instructions jaise aur videos mein the. All questions are compulsory. There are 26 questions in all. The question paper has 5 sections A, B, C, D and E. Section A has 5 questions of 1 mark each. Section B has 5 questions of 2 marks each. Section C has 12 questions of 3 marks each. Section D has 1 value based question of 4 marks and section E contains 3 questions of 5 marks each. There is no overall choice. However, an internal choice has been provided in one question of 2 marks, one question of 3 marks, and all the 3 questions of 5 marks weightage. You have to attempt only one of the choices of such questions. These are the constants which are there, which we may need, okay? And there are more constants which we don't have to ratify. So the marking scheme has the answers of this sample question paper from where we have taken the answers. Okay, now let us start with the first question. First section A. First question: in the given figure, charge plus Q is placed at the center of the dotted circle. Work done in taking a charge plus Q from A to B is W1 and from B to C is W2. Which one of the following is correct? W1 greater than W2, W1 equal to W2, or W1 less than W2. The answer is, as VA minus VB is equal to VB minus VC. Magnitude of work done is the same for mark. So this is the answer. Next, plot a graph showing the variation of current I versus capital R connected to a cell of EMF E and internal resistance small r. That means capital R is the external resistance. This is the graph. The equation is I is equal to E upon small r internal resistance plus capital R external resistance. State the factors on which the refractive index of a material medium for a given wavelength depends. As the velocity or the refractive index depends upon magnetic permeability mu of the medium and electric permittivity epsilon of the medium. Half half marks. Next question 4. Sketch the emergent ray. We have light. This is the wavefront, which is incident. Okay, now the rays go straight. This is the answer. The rays go straight and then they again get refracted. So the wavefront becomes like this. One mark. Next, in the wave picture of light, intensity of light is determined by square of the amplitude. That is, I is proportional to amplitude ka square. What determines the intensity of light in the photon picture? In the photon picture, intensity is determined by the number of photons crossing per unit time, per unit area. Okay, that is for one mark. Section B. An AC voltage E is equal to E naught sine omega t is applied to a circuit containing a resistor are connected in series with a black box. We have an EMF E connected to by a resistance R to a black box. That is, the current in the circuit is I is equal to I naught sine omega t plus pi by 4. State whether the element in the black box is a capacitor or an inductor. Here current is ahead of the voltage by pi by 4. Draw the corresponding phasor diagram and find the impedance in terms of R. So the answer is, as the current leads the voltage by pi by 4, the element used in the black box is a capacitor. Okay, half mark. The phasor diagram, this is VC and this is VR. Current is in the same direction as VR, that is I, and this is the net voltage EMF. This is the phase difference pi by 4. Now, applying tan phi, the formula was tan phi is equal to VL minus VC by R, or VC minus VL by R. L is not there. So, VC by R is tan phi. Phi is pi by 4. VC by R, VC by R. As VC is equal to VR, XC is equal to R. Okay. And the impedance is Z is under the root of XC square plus R square. Z is R root 2. Now, seventh question. The magnetic field in a plane electromagnetic wave is given by By is 12 B naught. This is B naught sine K Z plus omega T Tesla. Calculate the energy density associated with the electromagnetic wave and speed of the wave. Energy density is B square upon mu naught. B is given and mu naught we know. Speed is omega by K. This is omega and this is K. Next question. Eighth question. A spherical convex surface of radius of curvature 20 cm made of mu is equal to 1.5 is placed in air. Find the position of the image formed if the point object is placed at 30 cm in front of the convex surface on the principal axis. Okay. So, N2 by V minus N1 by U is N2 minus N1 by R. So, N2 is 1.5. N2, this is N1, this is N2. 1.5 upon V. V is 20 minus N1. N1 is 1 upon U is 30 is N2. Is 1.5 minus 1 upon radius of curvature R. Okay. That is 20. So V comes out to be minus 13.3 centimeter. This solution is something different, but we will get the same answer. Now, number 9. Name the optoelectronic device used for detecting optical signals and mention the biasing in which it is operated. So, we have a photodiode. It is having reverse biasing and IV characteristics are shown on NCRT page number 487. IV characteristics for a photodiode are like this. Reverse bias characteristics. First is the dark current, then we have intensity I1, then I2, where I2 is more than I1. This is I versus voltage V. Okay. Next question. Give reason why high frequency carrier waves are needed for effective transmission of information signals. So the answer is, need for long antenna diminishes with explanation of two lines at least. Second, power is inversely proportional to wavelength square. Third, signals from different transmitters can be distinguished, that is no mixing up of channels. This is for 2 marks. In or, what is the range of frequencies used for TV transmission? State two factors by which the range of TV signals can be increased. So, the range is 76 to 88 megahertz and 420 to 890 megahertz for 1 mark. Factors are by increasing the height of transmitting antenna and using repeater stations. 1 mark. Now, section C, 11th question. How many electrons must be added to one plate and removed from the other so as to store 25 joules of energy in a 5 nanofarad plate capacitor? So the capacitance is 5 nanofarad and the energy is 25 joules. U energy is Q square by 2C. So we calculate Q is equal to Ne. Q is 5 into 10 to the power minus 4 coulomb. So Q is Ne. So we calculate the number of electrons by quantization for 2 marks. How would you modify this capacitor so as to store 50 joule of energy without changing the charge on the plates? Without changing the charge on the plates, we can make C half. Capacitance is A epsilon naught by D. Double the plate separation or inserting the dielectric of constant value such that C becomes double. Okay, this is for 1 mark. Next, a point charge plus Q is placed at the center O, this is plus Q, of an uncharged hollow spherical conductor of inner radius A and outer radius B. Find the following: the magnitude and sign of the charge induced on the inner and the outer surface of the conducting shell. Inner surface is minus Q, outer surface will be plus Q. Okay. Now, as the electrostatic field is inside a conductor is zero, the charge on the inner shell is minus Q, outer is plus Q. The magnitude of the electric field at a distance r equal to a by 2. Expression for electric field for r equal to a by 2 over here. Over here the electric field is kq by r square. Kq, 4 is extra, kq by r square, or r is a by 2. So r is a by 2 whole square, that comes out to be 4 over here. Expression for electric field at radius r equal to 2b. R is equal to 2b. So in this Gaussian surface, minus q plus q cancels, only q is this there. So kq by 2b whole square. Okay, now next question. The following table gives the length of 3 copper wires, their diameters, length, diameter and the applied potential difference across their ends. Arrange the wires in increasing order of their magnitude of electric field within them. Okay, so their lengths, diameter and voltages are given. We have to arrange them in the increasing order of magnitude of electric field within them. Electric field is V by L, E1 is V by L, E2 is V by 2L, okay, V upon 2L, E3 is 2V upon 3L, E2 is less than, E3 is less than E1, okay. The drift speed of electrons through them, drift speed is proportional to electric field, so D2, like here, like the electric field, velocity in D2 is less than velocity in D3 is less than velocity in D1. The current density is J. Current is I is equal to NEA VD. J is equal to sigma E. So this becomes I divided by A is NE VD. So NE are constants. VD means that like VD, we have J2 less than, J3 less than, J1. Okay. Next, multi-range voltmeter can be constructed by using a galvanometer circuit as shown in the figure. We want to construct a voltmeter that can measure 2 volt, 20 volt and 200 volt using a galvanometer of resistance 10 ohm. This G is 10 ohm. And that produces a maximum deflection for current 1 milliampere. This is Ig. Find the values of resistance R1 for 2 volt. So the voltage 2 volt can be written as Ig into V, can be written as Ig into G plus R1. Let this voltage be V1, V2, V3. V1 is Ig, V1 is 2 is Ig. Ig is 1 milliampere. Capital G is 10 plus resistance R1 is here. Okay. In this manner we can calculate R1, similarly R2 and R3, each of 1 mark. Next question. Figure shows a metal rod PQ of length L resting on the smooth horizontal rails AB positioned between the poles of a permanent magnet. This is NCERT question. The rails, rod and the magnetic field B are in three mutually perpendicular directions. The galvanometer G connects the, this galvanometer G connects the rails through a key K. Assume the magnetic field to be uniform. Give the resistance of the loop containing the rod R. Okay. Now, this is the rod. Suppose key K is open and the, this is NCERT question which we have already done in NCERT. Yes. It is NCERT page 301, question 6.14. 1 mark for each part. Next. 16th question. With the help of a diagram, explain the principle of a device which changes a low voltage into a high voltage. That is a transformer, step-up transformer. Devices, transformer, step-up. Explain the principle of a, okay, but does not violate the law of conservation of energy. Give any one reason why the device may not be 100% efficient, because we already had assumed no energy losses, but in real transformer we have energy losses. I am assuming no energy losses. The transformer is 100% efficient, that is power in primary is equal to power in secondary. Next question, 17th. In a double slit experiment, the distance between the slits, this is small d, and the slits are 2 meter away, this is capital D. Two interference patterns can be seen on the screen, one due to the light of wavelength this much, let this be lambda 1, and the other due to light of wavelength lambda 2. What is the separation on the screen between the fifth order bright fringes of the two interference pattern? Okay. Now the fifth bright fringes 5d lambda by small d. So this is the position of fifth bright fringe of lambda 1. This is the position of fifth bright fringe of lambda 2. So we subtract both. So this is the difference. Okay. Now next question, 18th question. What do you understand by the statement light from the sun is unpolarized? Light from the sun is unpolarized means electric vector vibrates in all possible directions of the transverse wave plane rapidly and randomly. How does light, sunlight gets polarized by the process of scattering? Polarization of scattering by the method of scattering is page number 379 of NCERT part 2, diagram plus explanation. Okay. So you must have seen this diagram. This is the light from the sun, unpolarized light. This is the polarizer, and perpendicular to the polarizer in incident direction, the polarized light is seen by the naked eye. This is the scatterer in the atmosphere. Now question number 19. Explain how does number 1 photocurrent, number 2 kinetic energy of the photoelectrons emitted in a photocell vary if the frequency of incident radiation is doubled but keeping the intensity same? Photocurrent will be the same, kinetic energy will increase. Okay, show the graphical variation of the above two cases. So page number 391, figure 11.4 plus explanation, that is for 1.5 marks. Page 391, figure 11.4 explanation. Kinetic energy, that is page 392 plus explanation for 1.5 marks. Okay, now if the frequency is doubled, photoelectric current will be the same, intensity is the same. Let this be frequency mu 1, let this be frequency mu 2, that is twice of mu 1, and intensity is same. For kinetic energy, h nu is h nu naught or phi naught plus kinetic energy, that is EV naught, that is the maximum kinetic energy. If this is doubled, so the equation is 2h nu is equal to phi naught plus kinetic energy maximum dash. Phi naught remains the same, we can subtract it. So the change in kinetic energy will be equal to this minus this. Change in kinetic energy max is h nu. Next question is, in OR part, name the experiment which confirms the existence of wave nature of electrons, that is the Davison-Germer experiment. Derive the expression for de Broglie wavelength of an electron moving under potential difference of V volts. Okay, now if an electron E minus, let this be the negative plate, let this be the positive plate, is accelerated from here to here having a potential difference V. So the potential difference EV naught becomes the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is P square upon 2m, or P is under the root 2m K. K is the kinetic energy. So the de Broglie wavelength is H by P, becomes H upon under the root 2m EV. That is done in theory and in other videos also. Second part, an electron and a proton have the same kinetic energy. Which of these particles have the shorter de Broglie wavelength? Okay, we have just seen lambda. For same kinetic energy, lambda is inversely proportional to root m. So lambda of proton is less than lambda of electron for 1 mark. Next, question number 20. The energy level of an atom of element X are shown. Which of the level transition will result in the emission of photons of wavelength 620 nanometer? Support your answer with mathematical calculations. So the answer is here. Energy is Hc by lambda in joules. That is Hc by lambda E in electron volt directly. So what you can do is, you can calculate this much. This comes out to be 12.24 angstrom or nanometer or angstrom upon lambda. Okay, and I think this is nanometer. So we divide lambda. Lambda is 620. So it comes out to be 2 electron volts. Now, question number 21. Draw a graph with showing the variation of binding energy per nucleon versus mass number A. So binding energy per nucleon is this graph, which we have already done. Explain with the help of this graph the release of energy in the process of nuclear fission and fusion. This will be the fission, this will be the fusion. This is explained in our videos and in the NCERT on these pages. Next, question number 22. Message signal of frequency this much, that is omega m, and peak voltage 20 volts, that is am, is used to modulate a carrier frequency. This is omega c of peak voltage, this is ac. Determine the modulation index. Modulation index mu is am upon ac is 20/40 0.5. The sidebands produced, that is omega c plus omega m and omega c minus omega m. Okay, that is 2020 and 1980 kilohertz. Draw the corresponding frequency spectrum of amplitude modulated signal is something like this. On page 525 NCRT part 2. Okay. Okay, next is section D, value based question. When Deepak studied the electrical circuits and the current flowing through them, he became curious about the range of the currents we come across in daily life. He collected the data and presented in a tabular form as shown below. This is the serial number, description of the appliance, then the magnitude of current. Domestic appliances have few amperes, lightning has 10,000 amperes, nervous system micro amperes, galvanometer few milliamperes, semiconductor few milliamperes. Okay. Now, what values does Deepak have? Critical thinking, hard working, or good knowledge of physics, practical thinking. As domestic appliances carry electric current of the order of few amperes, write one safety precaution we should take while working with them. One should not touch electric appliances with wet hands or any other like rubber shoes, etc. Now, third, an emitter of resistance RA is connected in series. Resistance RA is connected in series with a resistor R and a battery of EMF E and internal resistance small r. The current flowing through this circuit is IA. The current is IA. So IA will be E upon small r plus capital RA plus capital R. What will be the current flowing through the circuit if the given ammeter is replaced by an ideal ammeter? If the ammeter is replaced by an ideal ammeter, so ideal ammeter has resistance as 0. So the current will be I is equal to E upon small r plus capital R. Okay. So what we have is IA is E upon small r plus capital R plus RA. For an ideal ammeter, RA is 0. So current becomes I equal to E upon small r plus capital R. The percentage error is I minus IA upon I into 100. So we calculate this. Okay. Next, section E, last section, carrying 5 mark questions. A particle of charge Q is moving with a velocity V in the presence of crossed, means perpendicular, electric E and magnetic field B. Write the condition under which the particle will move. Continue moving along X axis. Show how would the trajectory of the particle be affected if the electric field is switched off. Okay, let us have a charge here moving with the velocity V in the direction of E. There will be a force QE in opposite direction Q V cross B. So how would the trajectory of the particle be affected if the electric field is switched off? If the electric field is switched off, it will have a circular path like this. Write the condition under which the particle will continue to move. These forces become equal when V is E by B. Okay. That is the velocity selector. Next. B part. A horizontal wire AB of length L, mass M, carries a steady current I1. This is I1. Free to move in a vertical plane is in equilibrium at a height H. At a height H over another parallel long wire CD. This is wire CD. Carrying a current I2, which is fixed in a horizontal plane as shown. Derive the expression for the force acting per unit. We can derive this expression. The expression shall be mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I1 I2 upon the distance is R, which is H here, into length L. If this length is L. Per unit length on the wire AB and write the condition for the AB is in equilibrium. AB will be in equilibrium if the magnetic force FM, this is Fm becomes equal to Mg, this is equal to Mg. Okay, next, in the OR section, an electron in the ground state of hydrogen atom is revolving in a circular orbit of radius r. Obtain the expression for the orbital magnetic moment of the electron in the terms of fundamental constants. Okay, so this is the first section which we did, and the second is the angular momentum mvr is nh upon 2 pi. For a hydrogen atom, n is 1, so velocity can be written as h upon 2 pi mr. Time period is 2 pi r by v. So putting the value of v from here to here, it comes out to be this much. T is this much, current is charge upon time. Okay, so the magnetic moment comes out to be eh upon 4 pi m, that is also called as mu naught or Bohr magneton. That is done in the derivations and in the video of Earth's magnetism. Okay, now over here the next question is B part. Draw the magnetic field lines for a current carrying solenoid when a rod made of copper, aluminium, iron are inserted within the solenoid as shown. So the answer is diagram for magnetic field lines. Copper is diamagnetic, aluminium paramagnetic, iron is ferromagnetic. In diamagnetic, we will be drawing lines like this. This is diamagnetic. Paramagnetic like this, and ferromagnetic, all the lines will be passing through. This is ferromagnetic. Now next question, question number 25, A part. Draw a ray diagram of compound microscope. You should know for the final image formed at least distance of distinction D, which we have done in theory in all the videos, in the ray optics videos. B part. An angular magnification of 30x is desired using an objective of focal length 1.25 cm and an eyepiece FE is 5 cm. How will you set up the compound microscope for the final image formed at least distance of distinct vision? This is an NCERT question. Okay. Now, in OR part, draw a ray diagram of an astronomical telescope for the final image formed at least distance of distinct vision. Again, we have done in the videos of astronomical telescope in ray optics. Next, an astronomical telescope has an angular magnification of 5 for a distant object. The separation between the objective and the eyepiece is 36. That means FO plus FE is 36 and the final image is formed at infinity. So the magnification is plus FO upon minus FE. Calculate the focal length of the objective and the focal length of the eyepiece. This again is a NCERT question which we have already done. This is the solution. You can pause and see. This is NCERT question. Then again, telescope, NCERT question. Now the last question, 26th question. With the proper diagram, explain the movement of charge carriers through different parts of the transistor and hence show that IE is IB plus IC. This we have done in semiconductor electronics video. B part, identify the logic operation carried out by the circuit shown below and write its truth table. So over here is A, NAND gate will give A into A ka bar is A bar, B into B ka bar is B bar. This will give A bar into B bar ka whole bar is A bar bar plus B bar bar by De Morgan's law, that becomes A plus B. So Y is A plus B. This whole makes an OR gate. In OR part, draw a circuit diagram to study the input and output characteristic of NPN transistor in its common emitter configuration. This has been done in the video. In semiconductor electronics, draw the typical input and output characteristics, both the curves, and explain how these graphs are used to calculate current amplification factor. Okay, that is beta AC and beta DC. That has been done. 26th A part and P part. Now the diagram, input characteristics, output and the current amplification factor, which are there in the NCRT and in our videos also.